And I know that's not much of a surprise to you, but I think this may be. No one deserves to be in the Memphis Wrestling Hall of Fame any more than this man, Lance Russell.
Thank you, Dave.
Hello again, everybody. I'm Dave Brown right here at ringside, ready to go with another day of USWA Championship Wrestling. And what a proud day. I am very happy to introduce this man right here, Hall of Famer, joining us on the USWA Championship Wrestling Show, Lance Russell, back here with us today. Welcome.
Thank you very much, Dave. I got to tell you, there's something about that Hall of Famer that makes me feel any older, even older than I already am.
No,
what
no.
A delight, Dave, though. Just, I am tickled to death.
Well, we're thrilled to have you here. We know you're going to be with us from time to time. We'd love to see you here every week if you can be.
Yeah, the honest fact of the matter is, and we just will be honest, why not? Let's tell them the stuff. I am retired, and it looks like this is not work. This is fun for me. And the pure fact of the matter is the Legend Show was just so doggone much fun that it got my juices flowing again, and I've missed being around you and all the great fans and the wrestling and all of that. And the situation is we are going to miss some weeks, and Miss Audrey sitting there at home deserves to be able to go on some trips and things like that. And we've got a few golf tournaments we're going to be playing, but every week that I can and I'm here in town, I'm going to be right down here.
And we will be looking forward to seeing you every week you can. By the way, Corey's on vacation this week. He'll be back with us next week, too.
Yes, next week, so Corey will be back then. And we also are going to be down at Monday night at the Coliseum. I've missed that, too, so I'm looking forward to being there every week that we possibly can.
And around the territory as possible. Glad to have you here today. We got a big match coming up, the opening match here. We got Dream Machine coming in, been causing some problems. I know you've been keeping up with it. Got the new USWA tag team holders coming out here, and we'll also a little bit later on be talking to the USWA heavyweight champion all today.
We have got that and a bunch much more. The King will be here today. I'm absolutely sure of that. I'm looking forward to seeing that. Sounds to me like that it is one of those days that I really was looking forward to coming back for.
You're right. We'll be getting it underway here in just a moment. Stay with us. We're headed to the ring.
Well, what a fascinating guy this guy is, Dave. Really enjoyed watching him. Do not know him personally, but he is a specimen, and look at this guy. I can't believe
it. You're a big Jerry Lawler fan, but you missed the boat, man. You should have got with the Dream Machine 10 years ago.
I thought you'd have been in jail by now. That's what I thought. Gee.
Boy, talk about a guy holding a grudge. This guy held a 10-year grudge to come back and took a shot at Jerry Lawler right here on TV. Oh, the Spellbinder with one of his illusions throws it out toward the audience, and the Dream Machine nailed him from behind.
Solid right hand. Puts the Spellbinder down. He takes him over, drapes him over the top rope. Referee trying to back him up and get this thing back out in the middle of the ring, and with a clothesline that put him flat on his back.
I'm afraid the Spellbinder's in trouble here. He's the kind of guy that needs to set and really go throughout the entire match, and he's very effective when he does it. The Dream Machine. Oh, well, hey, there's a good move. That could turn the tables on the Dream Machine. Let's see.
The whip. Elbow. Spellbinder starting to make his move. Count of one, two.
Dream Machine, on the other hand, is the kind of guy that he will take that shot from behind. He will surprise you, and then he just doesn't let up. He's kind of like the old snapping turtle, won't let go till it thunders, and that's the way Dream Machine is.
Oh, look at him, Dave. Something went down into his tights while the referee is with Spellbinder, and I mean, that's all. Bang, he nailed him. Put it away, two, three, call it quits.
Spellbinder hit the mat, and it's all over, but you're right, for an object.
That's Jerry Lawler!
Yeah, that's Jerry Lawler. That's Dream Machine, and he hasn't changed one single bit. Can't believe the guy holds a grudge that long.
I know, a 10-year grudge, and then today he's going against a Spellbinder. We're hoping for a really good match. Not on what he had in his hand, but that fist was loaded when he popped it down.
He did have something in his hand. We got more of that big action coming up here.
We're going to be back to it in just a moment.
you, Dave. The surprise of my life was the taped fist match with Jerry Lawler and Dream Machine. That's a brutal kind of a match to begin with.
Absolutely, and I think Jerry Lawler talked about it when we talked to him a few days ago before the match, and he said, you know, it's one of those things where a boxer tapes the match and they're just like hard as rocks, and then they put the boxing gloves on.
Yeah.
No gloves here.
No gloves, just the tape. Let's take a look. Taped fist match. Dave's already told you what it is. Jerry Lawler, the Dream Machine.
Pay careful attention to who might be there at the end.
Yes. Oh, the sundown! Oh, boy! Here comes Jerry Lawler! Picks up the Dream Machine! Right down on that metal chair! Well, there I go there with your big one, Dick. You better dig through, Dream Machine! Because if this you hear me, he's just for you. That chair is a Dream Machine headed there. Was for him, and Lawler goes to work on it. The key up on the wall now. Dream Machine down. Lawler cuts the right hand down. Oh, the King says no. That's not enough. Not yet. Lawler again. Chops the right fist down on the Dream Machine. Oh, boy, I tell you. Jeff taking care of everybody with a shot in his way.
Can't believe it. I'm telling you, any friend of the Dream Machines can't be all good. Dave, what in the world happened with Jeff Jarrett?
That's not the Jeff Jarrett we used to know.
Hey, really?
That's Double J. I have no idea. I was shocked when I heard about it. Fans who were there were shocked. When he first knocked Lawler down, I saw him. It looked like he was saying something to Lawler.
Oh, he took time for a little speech, yeah.
I'm very curious as to what he said and why he came in there, and I hope soon we find
Man,
out.
Man, I can't believe it. You know, I saw Jeff's very first match. I know that you did, too, and it just, what a total shock. I guess it's a mystery. It certainly is a mystery to us. I hope we can find out a little bit more about it. We've got lots more action, tag action coming up. We've got the King coming in a little bit later, and all of that yet to come in a moment. Bit of footage that we saw left me shaking my head. Jerry, gotta get right into it and ask you. That footage you saw, Dave and I were just talking about it. What in the world has happened with Jeff Jarrett?
Well, I'm just going to say, I think, from what I've heard, of course, you know, after last Monday night, I was as confused as just about anybody. The last time I saw Jeff Jarrett, it was up in the World Wrestling Federation. He acted as friendly as ever, laughing, joking around. But I think the problem has been that week in and week out, apparently Dream Machine has been somehow getting in touch with Jeff as he's up in the WWF, and telling Jeff that I've been coming out here on TV week in and week out, knocking him, you know, saying all sorts of things about Jeff Jarrett. And I think probably anybody that's been watching this show, all of these people out here probably know, I haven't not mentioned Jeff Jarrett on this TV show, and I don't know when. I can't understand. I don't know what the deal is. I remember back probably, the week we had the Monday Night Memories.
Yes.
Jeff Jarrett sent in an interview from the WWF at that point, you know, saying something about how can we have a Best of Memphis match with him not in it. I may have made some sort of comment on that. I've been racking my brain trying to remember if I made a comment about it or not. But I don't even think I commented on that. I know for a fact that I have not been coming out here week in and week out talking and saying anything about Jeff Jarrett, but from what I understand, that is what Dream Machine has been telling him that I've been doing.
And he's been taking all this in from the Dream Machine, didn't come up to you man to man and say, hey, what is all this stuff?
No, as a matter of fact, as I said, I saw him just a couple of weeks ago in, I think it was Albany, New York, at a WWF TV taping, and, you know, it was a hectic situation, everything's busy, but he acted as friendly as ever. I mean, you know, and didn't say one word, didn't even mention the USWA or what was going on down here or anything like
Jerry,
that.
Jerry, I don't have to bring it to your attention because you are on the receiving end of it. That wasn't just a little casual, well, here's one for you, and then he walks away. He stayed there and deliberately was trying to maim you and beating on you and all of that. So this is not one of those things that's going to pass.
No, exactly right. As a matter of fact, I asked him exactly how long that tape was. That videotape that we watched was 6 minutes and 30 seconds long. So for about 6 minutes of that, that was Jeff Jarrett and the Dream Machine just trying to, as far as I could see, they're trying to put an end to my career. Now, Jeff Jarrett and Dream Machine, if you think that I'm going to take that lion down, you got another thing coming. But I understand. I'm not sure. Did they talk to them after the match?
We've got an interview with both the Dream Machine and Jeff Jarrett on it. Good time right now. Let's take a listen and see what they've got to say.
Well, Arm, I guess from now on, when I tell you I got a surprise for you, you'll believe me, huh? You'll believe the Dream Machine because the Dream Machine don't lie. If I tell you a rooster dips stuff, you can look under his wing and find some tuberose. Double J, that man has been knocking you, calling you yellow every single week right here on this TV. Lawler, I told on you.
Double J. That's exactly right, Dream.
I told you.
Yeah, that's right. You've been telling me. Jerry, this man right here has been telling me everything because I hadn't had the opportunity to be here in Memphis, Tennessee watch WMC TV every Saturday morning.
I've been out wrestling
in the WWF worldwide, but this man right here, he's called me every week and he's reported. And you know what, Lawler? You know what he said that you said?
He said it.
He said that I was scared of you?
He said it. He said it. I told him, Lawler. He said it, Double J.
Lawler, you said that you run me out of the USWA and run me clear up to the WWF.
That's just exactly what he said.
I can't believe you'd say that, Lawler.
Well, he said it.
And you know, the final thing, the straw that broke the camel's back, Lawler, is that he said that I was afraid.
That's exactly
that I was scared to come to the Best of Memphis match.
He said,
I want to let everybody know right now that I was up in the Big Apple.
That's right.
I was up in New York City wrestling that night. And Lawler, I want you to know, and certainly you know after tonight, that Double J ain't afraid of nobody.
I ain't scared of you, and I ain't scared of anybody.
So Lawler, I had tonight off. One of my few nights off. And next Monday night, I got another one. So you find you a partner. I got me one.
Yes, sir.
You find you a partner if you can.
He knocked you bad, Double J. You think it's over, Jerry Lawler? You take a long, hard look at my face. Every face tells a story.
We're Monday night. Huh? We'll get
him.
We'll get him, Lawler.
It'll never be over.
Well, there it is. It's going to be a whole lot different than coming in and jumping you from behind. But you've got to come up with a partner, Jerry.
Well, I've come up with a partner. You know, I guess the Dream Machine and Jeff Jarrett think that they're the only two guys that can be buddy-buddy. Well, in this profession, you don't always have to have your best friend as your partner. What you want to get when you come up with a situation like this is you want somebody that doesn't care who he hurts. You want somebody that doesn't care what he's going to do to somebody else. You want somebody that's not out there to win any beauty contest, not out there to win any popularity contest. You want somebody that's out there to do one thing, and that's hurt his opponent. So the man that I've asked to be my partner this week, and I'll be the first to admit, ordinarily I would ask Brian Christopher. But Brian Christopher has already got one of the toughest matches that he's ever going to have because his hair is at stake.
Yep.
And I know full well, anytime you got your hair at stake, that's what you got to concentrate on. So what I did, I asked the man that, like I said, I know what he's capable of doing because he's done a lot of it to me. But lately he's been trying to change his ways, and I'm going to give him an opportunity to prove to me that he is a changed man. All I'm asking that he do this Monday night is when we get in the ring against the Dream Machine, who is about three bricks shy of a load, and Jeff Jarrett, who thinks he's now the greatest thing since sliced bread because he's in the WWF, all I'm doing is asking this man to fight as hard with me as he has against me in the past, and I think he'll do that. I want to bring him out here right now. My partner for this match Monday night, a lot of people may say you're crazy, King, but I think I know what I'm doing. It's Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, and in the past few weeks, he's proved, I think, to me and everybody else by being partners with Brian Christopher, winning the tag team titles, that he is the man that is trying to change his ways.
Well, there it is. Eddie, Jerry selected you as a partner. You realize there's a lot on your back, not only just from the standpoint of the match, but a lot of people still have some questions.
A lot of people have questions about everything. I was standing back there listening to Jerry Lawler talk. A lot of things gone through my mind, too, and this is something I thought would probably never happen. And I got to tell you something. I never thought that you'd probably ever even want me to be your partner. I know it had to hurt you a little bit, though, just a little bit, to stand out here knowing that Brian Christopher couldn't be your partner and actually have to ask and know that you need me to be your partner this week, Monday night. Because you know deep in your mind and deep in your heart that you need me to be your partner. Because what you are up against is something that I know everything about. And I want you to understand something. I want all the people to understand something, too. You saw a little tape out here a little bit earlier when Dream Machine and Jeff Jarrett jumped you. And it was about 6 or 7 minutes there of them just beating on you. A lot of the guys went out of the dressing room to help you. Brian Christopher went out there, but Doug cut him off. Well, I just want you to know, when I was in the shower, when I came out, the dressing rooms had empty. If I had known, if I could have been there just a minute earlier, I would have been there for you. I want you to know that right now. You were talking about the Dream Machine a while ago being 3 bricks shy of a load. Dream Machine, I am 5 bricks shy of a load. I want Jeff Jarrett to know something. You think you're a pretty boy. Well, I think you're a sissy. You're a sissy boy. And I am going to step into the ring Monday night as Jerry Lawler's tag team partner. His partner. And we are coming after you two, the greatest and the best that you've ever seen, because he knows, Jerry Lawler knows, that I have no heart. I have a cold, cold heart. I have no heart, no feeling for anybody. So whenever he says, go after them, I'm going to go after them. And you know what the real reason is I want to get you guys? Because you're trying to end his career. And if anybody was ever going to do that, that's me. Nobody's going to touch Jerry Lawler until I say so. So you can just think of it as I'm going to kind of protect you and look after you in the future. I'm going to make sure these guys pay dearly for what they did to you. Also, Eddie Gilbert, I've said this many times, you got a long memory. Dream Machine has been thinking about stuff that happened 10 years ago. You've been thinking about stuff that's happened between you and I that goes back longer than 10 years ago. But I just want you to remember back about maybe 4 or 5 or 6 weeks ago, when you were in a ring and you thought you could trust the Dream Machine, and the next thing you found out, you were laying flat on your back looking up at Tommy Rich, Adam Bomb, and the Dream Machine trying to kick your brains out. You know he's a snake in the grass, and now he's converted Jeff Jarrett, and all I want you to do is Monday night, bring the biggest fireball you can muster up, because I can't think of a better sight than to see that long blonde hair of Jeff Jarrett going up in flames. And Dream Machine, I got something special for you. You talk about a surprise last week, I got a big surprise for you this week, pal. Right.
Looking forward to seeing it. Two of the very best in the business, Jerry Lawler, Eddie Gilbert, both with an agenda in there, but both on the same side. Going to be something else to see. Dave, time for that mega time.
Hey, you're exactly right. Boy, what excitement going to be coming up this week.
How about that, huh?
We'll check that entire card, but first, it's time to give away some groceries, literally, right here. Gift certificate coming up from the fine folks at Mega Market. We've been doing this for several weeks. You know how it works. There's a telephone number, 901-726-0551. If you are caller number 8, you win the $25 gift certificate for the groceries from Mega Market. Yeah, a little hold on to this right
that.
Here. Caller number 8, call now.
Okay, we have just seen an interesting pairing of two great ones when we see Lawler and Eddie Gilbert in there together. Additionally, it is going to be one of those situations with Dream Machine and Jeff Jarrett. I wonder how that's going to fare when the fire, the crucible of fire gets underway, how their partnership is going to go along.
And on either side of the ring, you have what I would have to say are not natural partnerships. These are guys that you wouldn't think Dream and Jeff would have been partners.
Right.
And there was a time, especially not too long ago, you would never have thought
that Eddie and Jerry would have been
funny. Yeah, good point. We'll be looking for it. It'll all be coming up, and we're going to be back with more of the information. No, of we got the entire
We'll do the entire card okay, right here while we're at it. Right. And, we got opening match coming up there Monday night is going to be the Spider going against the Spellbinder. Spellbinder kind of had a short day here today as he ran into a foreign object from Dream Machine. He'll be going against Spider number one in the opening match.
And then it's going to be the other Spider, Spider number two. He'll be going against Reggie B. Fine.
Battle of the Brutes coming up. The Moondogs Ronnie Lott. Boy, I tell you what, he bounces around. He's got 14 watches on his arm. He can keep up with the time. Can he keep up with the British bad breed? We're talking about the Rotten Brothers, Axel and Ian. Battle of the Brutes. That's one of those where, as Jackie Fargo used to say, you just buy a sack of popcorn, settle back, and don't worry about who wins. Just enjoy the action.
That's one of those great matches where you don't have to worry about whether your man is going to come through.
That's right.
Neither one of them, your man. You're going to be looking at a good tag there. A little bit later on, I hope to get Bert Prentice out here because I want to ask him about this loser leave town match with Ronnie Lott. Now, you hear it. One of these guys is going to be on the short end of that. Bert Prentice, Ronnie Lott's loser leave town.
Then you got the USWA tag titles at stake. The new USWA tag champions are going to be here a little bit later on today. Monday night, they'll be defending their belts. The Eliminators, tag champions, didn't take them long to win those belts once they got here. Monday night, they defend against Billy Joe Travis. Billy will have as his partner Spike Hubert.
Oh, yeah.
Spike has been here before. It's been some time now, but he's a real bodybuilder and all of that sort of thing, and that's going to be an interesting pairing.
Spike has been everywhere, and one tough guy and a good choice for a partner for Billy Joe. Then, a USWA title match. Listen to this. No time, no disqualification. We're talking about Brian Christopher going after the champion, Doug Gilbert. In order to get this one, Brian had to put his hair up against the USWA heavyweight title, and that makes some kind of heavy match indeed.
Boy, it sure does. Brian would love to have that title back. And you talk about things that are very important. Well, how about just that situation we talked about a moment ago? You were talking to the King and Eddie Gilbert about it. Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, Jerry the King Lawler are going to be partners. You put them against Double J, Jeff Jarrett, Troy Graham, the Dream Machine. All of them in the ring and get set just for wild, wild action coming up Monday night.
Yeah, there can be a lot of wrestling out of it, but somehow I think that will pass real quick. Jerry Lawler isn't forgetting what happened to him after being jumped by Jeff Jarrett and the Dream Machine. And the same thing is true with Eddie Gilbert. If he'll put it all in the right direction, man, what a battle that one's going to be, Dave.
I think you're right. I think Lawler's especially going to be focused on the Double J. All right, the Mega Market gift certificate. The winner, Gary Owens of Memphis, Tennessee. Congratulations.
All right,
Gary. And we'll do this again next week.
That sounds like a very good one to me. We've got other things to be reviewing. We're looking forward to seeing it Monday night. Be down there with us. How it happened. A couple of major title changes, Dave, in the heavyweight title of the USWA and the tag title. Let's take a look at this little clip right here, and we'll find out exactly how it came about.
Wally Suka!
Christopher Gilbert. Oh!
Surprise Body Eliminator. But what a move from Hot Stuff and Too Sexy. Christopher whips in time. Big kick from Christopher. Boy, he flattered that boot right in the side of his face. And there is one half of the USWA World Tag Team Champion. Puff off with a leg. Oh, watch it, though. The Gilbert Hoster there on the game. Christopher. No stop. The cane flies out of his hand. And Saturn, the Eliminator, hits Christopher in the back of the head and holds him up. Oh, three bad news. Three and it is. The Eliminators and Doug Gilbert will get the win in 12 minutes and 6 seconds. Doug Gilbert.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, lots of hardware has just entered the studio. There you see.
Heavyweight title.
Dave Brown, let's play a little trivia. Who is the USWA Heavyweight Champion?
Well, you are. You've got the belt. You're the champion.
Dave Brown, who is the USWA Tag Team Champion?
Well, the Eliminators are the tag team champions.
Yeah, they are. See, Brian Christopher, what you've done, you made history. You're the first man to lose two belts in one night. And see, Dave, he hasn't only lost belts. He's lost his girlfriend. He's lost his car. He can't play chess. He can't do anything. So what I'm saying, Dave, O'Brien has hit Skid Row. So when he come to me and started saying, ooh, he got it busted, I want my belt back. So what could I do but to say, all I want is to cut your sneaking hair off of your head. So, Dave Brown, what you're going to see this week is you're going to see the last of the idiot Brian Christopher with no hair. So go ahead and start calling Baldy, Baldy. And I'm going ahead and sending my tag team champion to the ring to destroy somebody.
Well, the Eliminators do, in fact, have a match coming up right here. They head to the ring. Doug's in their corner. He's happy, says Brian Christopher's the biggest loser ever. I forgot exactly what he said. But I tell you what, if he thinks Brian Christopher's done, he's got another thing coming.
Oh, boy.
He's happy today, but Brian Christopher is going to come looking for him, I guarantee you. The Spiders coming up here.
Yes.
These guys have really been looking good. They may be future USWA champions themselves, but they've got a tough one coming up here today.
Eliminators will not have the titles on the line today. It is a non-title bout, and we are underway with action as the Eliminators go flying across the ring. Reversal by the Spiders and double hip toss. They're working together well as a team right now, David.
The Spiders in control. And we may be looking right here at the makings of a new champion. That may not be as far in the future as we thought. This is a non-title match, but boy, if the Spiders can get a win over these Eliminators today. Hey, we've got a big story in wrestling news, huh?
Got to pay attention to that, but it has to be done first. Eliminators. Now, look at here. What an athletic move to come off that middle rope, but it did him no good. Beautiful drop kick. Down the line on the apron with a solid clothesline.
This is a match I've been looking forward to all week because when you see the Spiders on one side, Eliminators on another, you know you got top talent all over the ring. There's a double team right there by the Eliminators. These guys, people don't just walk up and hand you the USWA titles. We've seen people defend those titles in serious handicap situations where it was one against two, put a manager one against three. They're tough to win, but the Eliminators did take those belts in that recent match.
Good solid move right there, and the Spider hammer down onto the deck. Looks like we've had the tag up in the air. Is he going to go for the spike? It looks like it. On the shoulder, and slammed him down as he pounded him into the mat. 1-2, and he got that left shoulder up just in time.
I'm amazed. I thought it was all over. Yep. I thought the Spiders were history for today, but he's still in there, still in action, not very good shape at the moment, needs a tag.
Big solid right hand to the midsection. Out of the corner, the Spider comes belly to belly and takes him over and down. Got a 1-2, and again, good left shoulder comes up to save him from that three count, and that is what it takes. Boy, we could do dissertations for a month on what that extra beat means. You get a two count, it's a whole lot different than a three count.
I think it was Jerry Lawler that explained it so well once. He said, you don't care about counts 1 and 2. You're focused on making sure you stop the count before 3, so the two count sometimes will seem to come easily, but you're right about that third one.
Off the top rope and down with that knee, and he cranked him hard, caught him right below the chin, put him down on the map, and as he picked him, it looks like again that we're going to have another double team into the corner, missing with the double clothesline, get to the corner and make the tag. My friend, he catches it right across both eliminators, both of them go down. Now it's one-on-one on opposite sides of the ring. And Scott Bowden, the referee, not having much success in getting it back down to just 2 men in there. And beautiful move by the Spider. See what you mean, Dave.
He really popped him down. He's got him covered. Could he hold it for 20? I don't know, but the referee is trying to get it back to 1-1. What is it? Doug Gilbert's running out of ringside. What did he throw in there?
There's something in. Sure did. It looked like it. The Eliminator slips it over his hand, and as the Spider comes back to action, he catches one right on the top. 1, 2, 3. Call it over.
Well, the Spider had the Eliminator covered for a long, long time. Could he have held it for that third count? We'll never know. The referee didn't see it. And then Doug Gilbert came in and turned the tables, and these Eliminators have eliminated the Spiders for today.
Still have a little question mark on a win like that. We've always felt that way about it. We've got more action back in a moment.
And I know right here is always somebody wanting to jump on his back. You got a couple of them this week we're going to be looking for you to defend against down there at the Coliseum. What else is happening, Jerry?
Well, as you said, Lance, it's always... always something going on. I just wanted to come out here and take just a second. I know you're fixing to go over the out-of-town action and things that are going on around the area. Wanted to mention a couple of things real quick. Coming up next weekend, there's going to be a real, real big weekend. Next Saturday afternoon, want to remind everybody, so you put it on your calendars, out at Bluff City Autoplex. Our good friend Bobby Ward was down here a couple of weeks ago, and they are going to be having live wrestling right on their right on the car lot there at Bluff City Autoplex.
Get out of here.
Right. Absolutely free. Everybody can come on out there. I'm going to be out there. Brian Christopher, Eddie Gilbert will be there. It's going to be next Saturday afternoon at 1 o'clock. And I always like to say, and I've heard you say it a million times, if you've never seen, there's so many thousands of people. I mean, there are like hundreds of thousands of people that are literally watching this TV show right now that have never been to and seen wrestling live. They see it every week on TV, but have never seen it up close and live. Here's an opportunity. You can just drive over to Bluff City Autoplex, get out of your car right there. We'll be out in the parking lot with the ring set up, and see the matches live. And it's so totally different than it is on TV. I mean, you just can't imagine.
Jerry, can I interrupt and tell you that for a lot of people who've been watching it, but they haven't been in a long time, I can testify today, I feel it up and down the back, the little chills and all the excitement that goes on. Nothing like being there.
I'll tell you, the matches, the talent here in the USWA is tremendous. The matches have been great. I was just watching the match just then with the Eliminators and the Spiders. There's some moves in there. One of the best matches that I've seen in I don't know how long. The excitement in the USWA right now in the action is just tremendous. And next Saturday afternoon is an opportunity to come see it. It won't cost you a dime. It would be absolutely free. Then also want to mention next Sunday afternoon, we're going to be up in Union City, Tennessee. I've got a big softball challenge up there. The Union City All-Stars have put together a really supposedly tough team, and we're going to have a big softball doubleheader up in Union City next Sunday afternoon at Thompson Field at 1 o'clock. They're going to have a big fish fry. It's going to be really big, and that's sponsored by the Banks of Union City. We want to invite everybody out to that. One other thing before I go. This afternoon at 1 o'clock, to let everybody know where Bluff City Autoplex is, Bluff City Used Cars out there, it's at I-240 and Getwell, and I'm going to be out there this afternoon at 1 o'clock. just with some free pictures and some free tickets. So the first 100 people, that show up this afternoon there at Bluff City Autoplex or Bluff City Used Cars, which is at I-240 and Get Well, they get a free picture of the King and a free ticket to Monday Night Wrestling. That'll be at 1 o'clock today. Be there from 1 to 2.
You're going to have to slow down a little bit to get that golf game shaped up there. I played golf with this guy. I was amazed. Never played in his life hardly, and right back at it.
I'm playing a little game.
See, you played that softball up there in Union City.
That's it. And doing a little hacking on the golf course. And real quick, want to say hi to some very special friends of mine. Richard Nuttery is over here and a couple of his friends from SOS. Good pals. Can you get a shot of them right there? Right here on the front row. There they are right there. They did some great work with Children's Occupational Workshop, SOS, here in Memphis. And also, a very special friend of mine that you might have seen on the news a couple of weeks ago with the Make-A-Wish Foundation.
Uh-huh.
This guy right over there on the end, right on the very end. Can you see him? Where is he? There he is. Came out to my house and had a nice visit, and want to say hi to him and his entire family. They live out near Millington. They're watching today. And thanks for coming by and seeing us, okay? We'll see everybody at 1 o'clock today.
Okay, Jerry, thanks for being out here. It's time for us now to take a look, Dave, at what's going to be happening around the USWA territory.
There's going to be a lot of action coming up, and let's start with the big one in Crenshaw, Mississippi. You know, the King was talking about nothing like seeing live wrestling action. Nothing like seeing live wrestling action in Crenshaw. It is a different situation from the big arenas like Mid-South Coliseum, for instance. But I tell you what, you'll find some of the biggest wrestling fans in the world in Crenshaw, Mississippi, including the mayor, right?
Oh, yeah, Oscar Barlow. We got to say hi to him. And Oscar, I said I was going to be down there, and looking at the names that are on that card, you better believe. But I am going to be in Middle Tennessee and out of town, so I hope you'll give me a rain check on the next one. You don't wait for the rain check. Friday, Crenshaw, Mississippi, and you go by and tell the mayor, Oscar Barlow, hi.
Friday the 13th will be a lucky day in Crenshaw. Lawler, the Gilberts, Brian Christopher, the Spiders, the Dream Machine, probably more, too. Buy your tickets in advance. Save a dollar in Crenshaw, Mississippi. Coming up this Friday night should be a mighty big night. That was worth driving to see, too. Then on Saturday the 14th, the King was just telling you, the big live wrestling card is going to be free to the public at Bluff City Autoplex. That's a week from today, next Saturday. Lawler will be there. Eddie and Doug Gilbert both scheduled on the card. Brian Christopher will be there, too. Remember, that one is going to be free to the public. Make the plans in advance to come on out there. Friday, May 27th, Mark Tree, Arkansas. It'll be a little advance notice for you folks there at Mark Tree High School. Police Department sponsoring. And look at the names who are going to be there. At the bottom, Bert Prentice in concert. Well, okay. Bert will be there with a concert at 8 o'clock, Mark Tree, Arkansas, on Friday the 27th. Saturday the 28th, following night, Saturday night, wrestling returns to Jonesboro, Arkansas, Earl Bell Community Center. Jonesboro Wrestling itself is famous for all the top action that happens over there. And again, the next time we'll be there is on Saturday, May 28th. And then coming soon, wrestling in Brownsville, Tennessee, on June 3rd at College Hill Gym, and on June 10th at Ripley High School in Ripley, Mississippi. This coming Friday night, Crenshaw, next Saturday, Bluff City Autoplex. The one at Bluff City is going to be free to the public. Monday night, Mid-South Coliseum, huge action, of course, coming up there.
Boy, I love it. Got to take a real quick one here to say that noticing on the 27th there in Mark Tree, sponsored by the police department with the proceeds for the Special Olympics.
At
and
home.
That's one, what a great, great,
terrific.
Great thing that is. We got to take time out because we got a lot of action still to go. Don't you go away. Okay, we still got plenty of action. Good show.
Always a pleasure to see you. You know, Lane, earlier I was down here, I was watching Eliminators. Obviously, they do work out a little bit in the gym. Obviously, they do know a little bit about wrestling. But let me just tell you something, Lance. Those big muscles, well, I want to bring out a guy right now. Spike, come on out. Spike Huber, I want to show you some muscles. Where's he at?
Billy Joe calling Spike Huber out here, and here he comes.
Sure.
Come on, Spike. Now, Eliminators, if you want to talk about big muscles, take a look at this guy. He's got muscles in places you don't have places, punk. Take a look at this chest. Someday you might have a chest like this, but not right now. Someday you might have arms like this, but not right now. He knows a lot about wrestling. He's been all over the world. He's been in this sport for over 10 years. Now, punk,
Monday night in Memphis, Tennessee. There's no place like it. We're going to be the next USWA champions. The next morning, you will realize it. We are the champions. Stop to McFly.
I'll tell you what, brother. I appreciate the phone call, you know, because it's been a while since Spike's been in the squared circle, and you told me about these eliminators, the big tough guys. Well, you know, I thrive on big tough guys. I like competition, and I know I've got a good partner here, and I'll tell you what, come Monday night, they're going to find out what Memphis Muscle's all about, because that's what Spike Huber's all about. You got the heart, you got the determination, we got the wrestling ability. Watch out, eliminators. Spike Huber's ready. Believe me, I'm ready. I want to hurt somebody if that's what it takes, but I'll tell you what, you're my buddy, man.
Thank you, Spike.
I appreciate the call.
The bottom line is, we are the next champion.
Okay, Billy Joe Travis, Spike Huber. Good to see Spike again. I haven't seen him in a while. David.
All right, we're going to take a complete look at the Memphis card coming up Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum. Opening match, Spider will be going against the Spellbinder. The other Spider then comes back to go against Reggie B. Fine. Then you got the Moondogs with Ronnie Lutz going against the British Bad Breed, Axel and Ian Rotten. And then following that, you got Bert Prentice and Ronnie Lotz, and the loser leaves town. Yeah, maybe more about that coming up a little bit later. USWA tag titles at stake. The Eliminators will be going against the men you just saw, Billy Joe Travis, and man, what a large partner he's got in Spike Huber. The titles will be at stake. Then, in the USWA title match, the heavyweight title, no time limit, no disqualification. Brian Christopher's hair against the USWA heavyweight title, now held by Dangerous Doug Gilbert. Get ready for that one. Brian Christopher started a win streak, he said today. He's 1-0. He's going to be looking to make it 2-0 against Doug Gilbert.
You were saying no time limit, no disqualification. I'm thinking to myself, if he doesn't keep that win streak going, no hair. Add that no in there.
That's another no. You're right. And then, finally, the Grudge Tag Team match coming up. Double J, Jeff Jarrett, what was he doing here last week? I don't know for sure, except Dream Machine, I think, has been feeding him a lot of misinformation. Well, Dream Machine teams with Double J, Jeff Jarrett, to go against Jerry Lawler, and his partner will be Eddie Gilbert Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum. Here's the Dream Machine right here, and maybe he'll have some comments about the things he was telling Jeff
Jarrett. Well, I would not try to cripple and maim you, Lawler. You put four pins in a plate in my right ankle, and he has been knocking Double J, Jeff Jarrett, whether you people believe it or not.
You've been telling stories to Jeff Jarrett that got him all stirred up about that stuff.
Oh, I've been telling stories. You condone anything Lawler does.
No,
Lawler, he's scared. Let me tell you something, Lawler. Eddie Gilbert can't help you. Oh, Roberts won't be able to help you when we get through with you because Jeff Jarrett is flying in from New York. Eddie Gilbert, you want to stay out here and tell the people that you was back in the back? You were taking a shower is the reason you didn't help Lawler? I don't think so. You were scared, Eddie Gilbert. That's the reason you didn't come out here and help Jerry Lawler. Lawler, you've been coming out here every week and telling these people that the Dream Machine's going to kick the oxygen habit and my poor mama won't recognize me. Well, I'm still here. And I told the people that me and the Mouse from the South had a big surprise. Well, we had it, and we done it, but you people sitting at home, you thought that was a surprise last week. It's nothing what I got in store for you this week, Lawler, because I guarantee you, Lance, you've been around a long time. You know the history. Lawler, you're going to take a long ride this week, all the way to that man, John Gaston, whatever you want to call him. Eddie Gilbert, don't show up. It ain't going to do you no good. Five bricks down the road. Scott
Friedman
ain't gonna help you when I get through with you Monday night.
Yeah. Well, I gotta tell you, this guy just rambles on and on. We'll see how far he rambles. Back in a moment.
Appreciate your fans for supporting me rather than jubilation. Well, he's got the smile. I don't know. Maybe I've misinterpreted the situation, but Brian does not have the USWA heavyweight title around his waist right now, and I know that is not a pleasant situation for you, Brian, not to have the title.
You know, Dave, I've had a real rough week. It's been pretty miserable. You know, I used to have the USWA heavyweight title,
yep,
along with the USWA tag team title.
Right.
And you saw Doug Gilbert come out here not too long ago, and he had the USWA title, my belt, around his waist, and his boys, the Eliminators, had me and Eddie Gilbert's tag team belt. Well, Doug Gilbert, you know, one problem with Doug Gilbert is that when he opens his mouth, words come out. And not usually, but every time words come out of his mouth, they're lies. And he sat out here and he told a bunch of lies. And I'm here to set the record straight. Now, Doug Gilbert, today, he did say one thing, maybe two things that were true. And I couldn't believe it. He said that he did beat me for my belt, and the Eliminators beat me for the tag team belt. Well, Doug Gilbert, you didn't beat anybody. You might have won the match, but you had a lot of help. And the same goes for the Eliminators. But Doug Gilbert, I'm making a vow today, and I want you, I want everybody sitting at home, everybody out here, I want you to get a piece of paper. And I want you to make a win column and a loss column, and then you put my name at the top. And you talk about confidence. I got a lot of confidence in myself, and that's why I'm starting a winning streak here today. I want you to keep it down. Each and every match I have, I want you to keep a win and a loss column and mark it down, because I'm not planning on losing any more matches. I'm a winner. I know I'm a winner, and I plan on proving it to everybody. Now, this week, I got my hair at stake. And that's a big, big match to put your hair at stake, right?
Absolutely.
You gotta be confident in yourself,
you
don't
sure
you?
Do.
Well, Doug Gilbert, I know I can beat you. Everybody knows I can beat you, and you know I can beat you. And you call yourself dirty, Doug Gilbert. Well, you're about to find out how dirty, how mean, and how nasty Brian Christopher can get. And I'm gonna prove it to you this week. I'm not losing another match. You're mine, boy.
Brian Christopher, the hair's at stake this week. There's no doubt about it.
I'm starting right now. You keep this down, Lance, Dave. I'm starting right here. You mark it down.
He heads to the ring. Ken Rafer's his opponent, Kevin Christian, the referee. And Brian says he's not all that worried about losing the titles because he's starting a winning streak, and it starts right now. Let's see what happens as he climbs into the ring in a one-fall 10-minute time limit match against Ken Rafer. Kevin Christian checking the warm-up jacket and just about ready for the action to get underway. Brian Christopher, I got to tell you what, Doug Gilbert better keep one thing in mind, and that is not only that Brian's hair's at stake, but also that Brian has been known to do whatever it takes to win a match, and you throw in that hair stipulation, don't make it even tougher.
Well, he mentioned he's starting a winning streak. He's got to start it with this match right here. He is on a losing streak, and that's one that I'm sure Ken Rafer would like to extend. But the one that he better make sure he wins, because it'll be with him a long time, not just that title. But if he loses it and loses that hair, that's one that you better be sure you win, Dave.
You know, I was just thinking during the interview, and I didn't want to point it out because I know Brian is very focused, but I hope he will consider the fact that he's never lost his hair in a match. He's had his hair at stake, I remember, at least once, but he hasn't had that hair shaved off bald. That's a pretty humiliating thing for a guy especially like Brian,
and
with all the confidence he has.
I got to come up with one that I hate to say it almost do, but I will, and that is an old saying, there's a first time for everything.
That's
so
true.
I hope we're not talking omens. Ken Rafer, underneath on that particular move. Look at that Christopher going. Big hip toss. Takes Rafer over and down.
Brian, of course, is a young man, but I go back many years to one of the all-time greats, Jackie Fargo. Got his hair shaved in a match.
Yep.
And it really affected him. And it wasn't too long after that that Jackie decided to hang him up and retired soon after that.
Yes, sir. It happens to everybody. You go to that water enough time, you're going to get wet on some of them. And there's Raper. Takes one. Solid, beautiful, stiff leg right in the top. Kent Raper down in the middle of the ring. Brian up. He's got a long fly. Comes out there with a leg and a beauty. This ought to be it, Dave.
We got it. Well, the losing streak is over for Brian Christopher. In the won and loss column, yeah, it's a W. It's a W1L0. That's the record beginning just moments ago for Brian Christopher. He's happy about it. The fans are happy about it. Ken Raper's not very happy. And Doug Gilbert should be worried about it, I tell you.
Well, he got it started on the right track, and this was the day he had to do it if he was going to get it started. A couple of big ones, the British Bad Breed, the Rottens, Ian and Axel right here, and these guys have got some major league action coming up.
Lance Russell, let me make one thing perfectly clear. Everywhere we've gone around this stinking country, all we've heard is moondogs, moondogs, moondogs.
Understandable.
If you're going to be the top dog in the USWA, they say Axel and Ian Rotten, you got to take down the big dog, the moon dog. Well, they ain't so big when it comes to Axel and Ian Rotten, Lance Russell. Gee, since busting heads is our business, and now that we're in the USWA, business is real good. Tell them, Axeman, you know something, USWA fans all over the country, people say, hey, can you guys beat the moon dog? Can we beat the moon dog? I had a dog one time, Lance Russell. Let me tell you a little story. People say, well, dogs are little pets, you pet them. Dogs aren't pets. They're something you kick around, smack, just like we're going to do to the moon dog. Come USWA time, moon dog, guess what? Move over, little dog. The big dogs have moved in.
That's a tall order. We're going to find out whether they can back it up. Back in just a moment.
Here, I really am. I hope I'm here next week. Eddie Marlin calls me midweek and says, Ronnie Lotz is asking for a match. I said, no problem. We've already put a diaper on him, spanked him. What does he want? Eddie Marlin says, no, he wants a loser leave town match. Well, the Carson flags are coming up. Ronnie Lotz asking for a match with me, a loser leave town match. So obviously, them idiot moondogs or whoever else he's got standing by is going to be watching everything in that match. So I'm going to have the spiders. I'm going to have Brian Christopher, Spellbinder, watching my door, too. And if anybody tries to interfere in that match, it's going to turn into one big battle royal, because I'm not leaving, I hope, anyway.
Okay, well, Bert, good luck to you, Dave. Double J's.
Double J. Wrestling fans in this area know Jeff Jarrett very well. I'm not sure how well everyone knows Double J. Take a look at this. the same young man we were such big fans of when he was around here.
I can't believe it. Different really hard attitude. To believe. Well, next week,
number 900. This is show number 899 in this studio. Next week, the special 900 show. Lots of special things coming up. Reggie, what do you want?
Let me tell you something. Hey, you weren't here last week, Lance Russell.
No, I wasn't.
Jerry Lawler tried to break my leg last week, and I want revenge, so I asked the promoter to sign me this match. I'm going to kill this punk today.
Kill this punk today? Did I hear him say that?
Last week, Jerry put something out. At the time, I didn't know what it was called. It was called the Royal Grapevine. He did almost. He could have broken it. If things had been just slightly differently, it's a punishing hold he put on him. I can't believe Reggie would come back and ask for more. I would think he would tell the promoter, I don't ever want to wrestle Jerry Lawler again.
I think we got a tape on that, Dave, of exactly what happened.
All right, here it is right here. Watch this. Watch him spring back on it. Boom. Oh, my goodness.
That extension on that.
Yeah. He wraps that leg around his arm. Back on it, and the king calls it the Royal Grapevine. Look at him, just kind of wiggling that foot, putting pain on there. Great, it was a submission. Reggie gave it up. Yeah, had to give it
and
up.
And he's
right
back
there.
He's asking for another match.
Yeah. Well, head on in there, Reggie. Let's see what happens. The king very confidently steps up on the ring apron, and he'll be taking off the robe, handing the crown out. The crown's already in the safekeeping of one of the security folks. And we're going to be set to go with a rematch right here. Reggie jumps in just at the opening bell.
Referee Scott Bowden calls for the bell, and Reggie wasn't waiting on it. He goes right after him. I'll tell you, he's got the determination going for him.
He's got the chokehold going right there, too.
Yeah. Wheels that right hand around and nails Lawler. Ooh. And again. King put down on the deck by Reggie B. Bond.
Reggie's got the measure of revenge here, but it's not over.
Yeah, I've heard that comment before. I want to kill that punk today, you know. Lawler's still walking the talk. Look at Jerry. Wheels that right there.
Yep, different thing. The king pulls up strap and headed for Reggie, and boom, his head bounces off those turnbuckles. Down to the mat he goes.
Oh, look, Dave. Is he going for that Royal Grapevine?
That's it.
Again. He's got it. Whoa. A feel for it right in that knee, because all that pressure is going to the outside and just stretching it on the inside. Look out.
Dream Machine. But look over here. You got Eddie Gilbert keeping the Dream Machine out of the action. Meanwhile, the referee says Reggie B. Fine has had to give it up again. Yeah. Dream Machine was going to come sneaking in there and hit Lawler from behind, but Eddie Gilbert saw him coming. He was watching, too, and he was watching the king's back. That bodes well for the match they've got coming up a little later on. Meanwhile, Reggie B. Fine is in pain and agony as he holds onto that left knee. He was a victim not once, but now twice, and he asked for it, literally. He asked for the rematch.
Think maybe he will keep his mouth shut maybe next week about another I'm not sure about it.
I'm not either. If he's smart, he will, though. That's the match as the king gets the victory over Reggie B. Fine. We better check time.
Yes, sir. We'll check it and be back.
Monday night, opening match Monday night, Spider going against Spellbinder, and then the other Spider will be taken on Reggie B. Fine in a single match.
And the Moondogs, Ronnie Lotz, going against the British Bad Breed, Axel and Ian Rotten. That one, the Battle of the Brutes, should be a good tag match.
Loser leave town match coming up then, and I must tell you, a few months ago, I would have paid half the bus ticket to get Bert Prentice out of here, but right now, we've kind of grown to like him a little bit. He changed his attitude some time ago, and now it's Ronnie Lutz we'd like to see
leave.
It's
all perspective.
Yeah. Whoever loses a match is out of the USWA.
USWA tag title match. The Eliminators, are relatively new holders of those titles, will be taking on what should be a formidable challenge from Billy Joe Travis and Spike Huber.
And the USWA heavyweight title is at stake. This is a special one. Brian Christopher had the belt. He lost it to Doug Gilbert. But as he pointed out, Doug had a lot of help. Well, this week, make it no time limit, no disqualification. Brian Christopher's hair against Doug Gilbert's title. And as you pointed out, no time limit, no DQ. If Brian loses, no hair.
And then that final match, man, this son of a gun is worth the price of admission if they didn't have another bout on there. And that is going to be the pairing of Double J, Jeff Jarrett, and the Dream Machine going against the King, Jerry Lawler, and Hot Stuff, Eddie Gilbert.
Look for it Monday night. It's great to have you here today. We'll be looking for you back frequently. And next week, the 900th show.
Next week, the 900th show, and I wish I could be here, but I'm going to be talking to golf, be up in Middle Tennessee playing a little golf.
See you in a couple of weeks.
Enjoy it, Dave.
See
really
you
enjoy
next
it.
Next week. Till then, for Lance Russell, I'm Dave Brown. So long, everybody.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of USWA Championship Wrestling.